102. This is new this morning. Backcountry.com now apologizing for going after small businesses using the term backcountry in their company names.
Well, and it's sparking a big backlash on social media. Some local businesses here in Colorado say the apology is too little, too late. Let's get over to Emily because she's been following this story. And backcountry.com is a pretty popular website based out of Park City, Utah, and they've been around only since the mid-90s. Some of these businesses that are using the word backcountry have probably been around longer.
Exactly, and I think another argument here is it's like trying to trademark mountain or ocean and things like that, and so people are just really frustrated with this. And what we did here is we pulled a list of all of the companies that Backcountry has gone after for trademark violations, and what you'll see is in a lot of these names, they all have Backcountry in them, and another theme on this list is that almost every single one of these is a small business. We spoke with the founder of what used to be Backcountry Denim, Jordan Phillips. He's now based in Boulder, and he spent a frustrating 2 years trying to defend his company against Backcountry.com, who went after him for trademark violations. The massive online retailer sued with 7 different federal lawsuits, and in the end, unfortunately, Phillips' small business just couldn't afford the federal litigation. He can't say exactly how this legal mess ended, but we do know both his website and social media had to be taken down, and that's why he says this apology from this giant e-commerce site is just meaningless to him. The company's CEO finally posting this open letter on the website saying that it made a mistake, it wants every business to thrive, and it's misjudged the impact of its actions. And while this company has apologized, I can tell you it certainly has not quieted the anger on social media. In fact, there's a group out there that is called Boycott Backcountry. There's already 18,000 members all focused on spreading the message of boycotting the company. Been following this for a few days now, and unfortunately, that group on Facebook just continues to grow by the hundreds every hour.
Well, this company, they've apologized, but stopped short of anything else, right? They're not going to go over to these businesses and help them out.
Help them out.
Get them back on their feet.
Well, and now a lot of them have already rebranded,
launched
new websites, so it's too late to then go back to their old name, but they're all frustrated.
Well, it is frustrating, and I can tell you, I worked in Utah, so I know a lot about Backcountry.com. They're a company that started out of a garage with a couple of guys in Park City.
So they should know.
They should know.
Yeah.
And they only changed their mind after doing this for over a year and getting some backlash. They didn't do it out of the kindness of their heart. They did it because they got social media backlash.
Yes, and in their apology, too, they said they were trying to defend their name. And a lot of these small businesses argue that they were no competition to Backcountry.com. I mean, they are very small mom and pop shops.
Well,
yeah, exactly.
I get it. You get lawyers involved in anything, and things get kind of wonky, so I understand that. Thank you, Emily. Appreciate it.